The song was Tonight You Belong to Me. The year was 1956. I'm Kathy.
I'm Janet.
I'm Mimi.
And we're the Lennon Sisters.
And these are the sounds of the time.
The song reached number 15 on the charts, less than a year after the Lennon Sisters made their national TV debut on The Lawrence Welk Show.
And at the time, our oldest sister, Dee Dee, or Diane, was going to school with Lawrence Welk Jr. at St. Monica's School. They were both 15 years old.
Peggy was 13, Kathy 11, and Janet just 8. But they were already performing at local venues in L.A. Lawrence Welk Jr. had heard them and arranged for them to sing for his father at their home.
He walked out and all he did is sit on the couch and he said, "My son told me you can sing, sing." And it was so scary for us.
We were so little. So Kathy went over and plunked the note and we sang, "He can turn the tide and calm the angry sea." And Mr. Welk said, my, I'm impressed." And then he got his musical director on the phone and we sang to him on the phone. And they decided to have us on Christmas Eve, 1955. And we were on every Saturday after that.
Every Saturday for the next 13 years, dubbed America's Sweethearts of Song. They recorded their first album, Let's Get Acquainted, in May 1957.
And in those days, you could go in and do an album really in 2 days for sure, sometimes in 1 day. You did everything live. They didn't have tracks, so the band couldn't goof up and you couldn't goof up. Anybody who goofed up, you'd have to go back. So we could do 12 songs in a day, and then that was your album.
The Lennon Sisters were so popular that there was a huge market for merchandising tie-ins, from coloring books to cutout dolls.
TV was so new. I mean, this was this little box that people sat home. Movies, theaters didn't get as much money anymore because everybody wanted to watch that little box in their living room. And we were on every single week. There wasn't that much choice.
In 1960, Diane left to get married, and the quartet became a trio until she returned in 1964. By then, their younger sister, Mimi, was able to fill in when needed.
Throughout all the years, when she got old enough, teenager, when we'd get sick or pregnant, which we did a lot,
sick and pregnant.
We would call Mimi and say, "Okay, we're going to Caesar's Palace in a few months. Yeah. You got to learn Peggy's harmony and her choreography, and you've got to wear Peggy's clothes." And yeah, she was always there.
In 1968, the group decided it was time to leave the Lawrence Welk Show and branch out on their own. It wasn't long before they landed a musical variety show alongside Jimmy Durante on ABC.
Amazing thing that when we had our show with Jimmy Durante, we got the tail end of the fabulous television shows in vaudeville. There was George Burns and Bob Hope and Jack Benny. Yeah. And, you know, Desi Arnaz and all these people that would come on the show. And when we're watching this incredible thing happen with these fabulous stars.
The show lasted for just one season, though, and in the early 1970s, the sisters became regular guests on The Andy Williams Show. They later toured with Williams, performing frequently at Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas.
He was family to us. I mean, we just adored him and his family.
I always love to say he took us from young women to sophisticated ladies, the Bob Mackie gowns. It was just different, a fabulous choreography and wonderful vocal arrangements. Mm-hmm. And he helped to change our life and have us move on.
But in the era of sex and drugs and rock and roll, it became harder for the squeaky clean Lennon Sisters to find a platform. They began to spend more time on the road, appearing at charity benefits and convention halls. In 1994, the quartet found a steady home in Branson, Missouri, headlining at the Welk Champaign Theater. When Peggy retired in 1999, Mimi took her place in the sister act. And after Diane left for good in 2001, the quartet again became a trio. The three continued to entertain audiences in Branson until 2012, and they still appear there every Christmas alongside the Osmond Brothers for their annual show at the Andy Williams Moon River Theater.
We'll just give you a hint of our Christmas show.
So have yourself a merry little Christmas now. Merry Christmas to you.
There you go.
There you go.
God bless you all. Thank you.